A little bit about the author, Neal Stephenson, aka Satoshi Suspect Numero Uno. This guy is uncannily prescient of the American cultural temperament. You're on to something. But his breakthrough didn't come until 92, when Snow Crash hit the scene like a tsunami, a cyberpunk novel that fused memetics, computer viruses, and other high-tech themes with Sumerian mythology, along with the sociological extrapolation of extreme laissez-faire capitalism and collectivism. Oh yeah, and it's funny. Like, really funny. Whoa. Starring hero protagonist, the ultimate hat.
You can keep wearing your favorite sweatpants.
Stephenson's novels have influenced many aspects of pop culture, film, and TV. Snow Crash is credited with popularizing the concept of the metaverse, a virtual reality space that resembles the internet and the emptying of Zuckerberg's wallet. The novel was also the inspiration for the Matrix trilogy. Thank you very much, Keanu Reeves. The Diamond Age features a device called the Young Lady's Illustrated Primer, which is similar to modern tablets and e-readers, while Fall, or Dodge in Hell, features a fictional digital afterlife called Bitworld, which is similar to the concept of mind uploading. In other words, Stephenson is widely regarded as one of the most visionary and imaginative writers of our time, and I argue that Cryptonomicon will come to be seen as his most important work and the legacy of a true paradigm-breaking book. In its text, he explores the themes of cryptography, mathematics, and computer science, as well as the consequences of war, technology, and greed. Sounds like a mindbender, no? Part 2. How Cryptonomicon led to the creation of Bitcoin. Time to dive into the nitty-gritty of the text, folks. Cryptonomicon focuses on cryptography, digital currency, and the social and technological implications of a post-government world. The novel's divided into two parallel narratives, one set during World War II, following the exploits of a group of codebreakers and covert operatives, and one set in the late 90s, i.e. contemporary to the writing, following the descendants of the previous characters as they attempt to create a data haven in digital currency in Southeast Asia. Widely regarded as one of the most prescient science fiction novels of the last three or four decades, especially in relation to the development of Bitcoin, the first decentralized cryptocurrency, which was launched in 2009 by an anonymous person or group using the pseudonym Satoshi Nakamoto. We're going to explore some of the similarities between Cryptonomicon and Bitcoin, with multiple examples of the ideas from the novel that have influenced cryptography and digital currency. Part 3. Cryptography. Cryptography is the art and science of secure communication. Using techniques such as encryption, decryption, hashing, digital signatures, and public key systems, cryptography is essential for both Cryptonomicon and Bitcoin, as it enables the characters and users to protect their privacy, security, and identity in a world where governments, corporations, and hackers are constantly trying to spy on, censor, or manipulate each other. In Cryptonomicon, cryptography is used by both sides of the war to encrypt and decrypt messages, as well as by the modern-day protagonist to create a data haven called Gododengo Network, GDN, where information can be stored and transmitted without interference or regulation. The novel features several historical figures who were pioneers of cryptography, such as Alan Turing, John von Neumann, Claude Shannon, and Rudy von Hackelheber. It also introduces fictional characters who are experts in cryptography, such as Lawrence Waterhouse, Randy Waterhouse, Abby Halaby, and Enoch Root, whose name will ring many bells if you've read other works by Stephenson. One of the most important concepts in Cryptonomicon is the idea of a one-time pad, which is a method of encryption that uses a random key as long as the message and is used only once. A one-time pad is theoretically unbreakable as long as the key is truly random, securely distributed, and never reused. In the novel, Lawrence Waterhouse devises a scheme to use one-time pads to communicate with his friend Alan Turing, using pages from a random book as the key. He then invents a machine called Aquinas, which is capable of generating truly random numbers by measuring quantum phenomena. Likewise, Bitcoin also relies heavily on cryptography to ensure its security and integrity. Bitcoin transactions are verified by networked nodes through cryptography and recorded in a public distributed ledger called a blockchain. Bitcoin uses several cryptographic algorithms and protocols, such as SHA-256 hashing function, elliptic curve digital signature algorithm, ECDSA, Merkle trees, proof-of-work consensus mechanisms, similar to what Ethereum uses now, and peer-to-peer networks. Bitcoin also uses public key cryptography, which allows users to generate pairs of keys. Think smart contracts. One public key that can be shared with anyone, and one private key that must be kept secret. The public key can be used to generate a Bitcoin address, which is like an account number that can receive payments. The private key can be used to sign transactions, which are like digital checks that authorize payments from one address to another. One of the long-held intrigues and mysteries of Bitcoin is that its creator, Satoshi Nakamoto, sounds a bit like Neal Stephenson's character names, has the initials. Satoshi Nakamoto's initials are SN. Neal Stephenson's are NS. Do you feel a conspiracy theory coming on here? Some people have even speculated that Neal Stephenson is Satoshi Nakamoto, or at least was involved in the creation of Bitcoin with the team. While there's no conclusive evidence for this claim, it is undeniable that Stephenson's novel anticipated many of the features and challenges of Bitcoin today. Part 4. Digital currency. Digital currency is a form of money that exists only electronically and is not controlled by any central authority or intermediary. Digital currency can be used for online transactions or stored in digital wallets. It can be either centralized or decentralized. Centralized digital currencies are issued and regulated by a single entity or organization. Think a corporation, an NGO, a state, a nation. Whereas decentralized digital currencies are created and maintained by a network of users who follow a set of rules or protocols. In Cryptonomicon, digital currency is represented by the Kinakuta Rupiah, a fictional currency issued by the made-up nation of Kinakuta, a small island in Southeast Asia which hosts the Goto Dengo network. The rupiah is backed by gold stored in a secret vault under GDN's headquarters. It's convertible to other currencies through an online exchange system called Epiphyte 2, a company founded by the protagonists. Epiphyte 2 uses cryptography and digital signatures to verify and process transactions, as well as to protect the identity and privacy of its users. Bitcoin is often described as digital gold because it shares some of the properties and functions of gold, such as scarcity, durability, portability, fungibility, divisibility, and that it is, in fact, a store of value. Cryptonomicon was one of the first novels to explore the concept and potential of digital currency in a realistic and detailed way and adoption of Bitcoin. For example, Roger Ver, one of the most prominent Bitcoin investors and advocates, famously met Stephenson in 2014 and gave him a first smartphone loaded with a Bitcoin wallet. The novel also predicted some of the challenges that digital currency would face, especially in terms of the SEC. Cryptonomicon is a novel that not only tells an engaging story of codebreakers, hackers, entrepreneurs, and adventurers in a fraught wartime context, but it also foreshadowed the emergence of Bitcoin, the first decentralized cryptocurrency, which has revolutionized the world of finance and technology. The novel demonstrates a remarkable vision and understanding of cryptography and digital currency, as well as their social and political implications for today and